What's up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be covering a brand new DLC weapon. A huge shout out to Wisco. He follows me over on Twitter. I was able to get on his account because I opened a shit ton of supply jobs and I was not able to get this gun. So he let me hop on his account so I can use it to bring it to you guys. So if you're watching this, thank you very much. He actually has the Epic Capitan, which is Spanish for Captain. It's really, really insane. Now, the Capitan is the Gore 43. It's just like an Epic version. Or better yet, an Epic variant. In this game, we have certain weapons that are like kind of like smaller than others. We have the really tiny sniper that I brought gameplay on. The Capitan is practically the small variant of the Gore 43. Besides the heroic, I think this is probably the best looking one. I mean, the texture is cool. It's black and gold. I mean, I don't know how you can beat black and gold. It's a pretty sick combination. I haven't tried it yet. I've only, like, obviously equipped it here on the firing range and looked at it. I'm not even gonna lie. It's Saturday. It's raining. I didn't even want to make a video today. I just wanted to sleep in all day, play with my son, and just, I don't know, watch movies or some shit. This weapon has a major, major drawback. And as you can see, it's only got 30 bullets, and that is shitty as... Wow, that's really shitty. So what I'm gonna have to do probably for right now, I haven't obviously used the weapon, but just right off the bat, I want to assume primed is probably a good bet. This weapon only shoots one bullet at a time, so prime is gonna help us a little bit with that flinch, even though it's been nerfed drastically, but every little bit helps. That's not primarily why I want to use this. I want to use it because this weapon has no bullets in the magazine and I don't have extended mags unlocked yet. Fuck me. What I wanted to do was unlock extended mags to actually increase my magazine size by just a tad bit. But since I don't have it, what I'm going to have to do is probably just put on, I don't know, maybe a reflex sight for now. Quick draw, foregrip, and a reflex. And I forgot to show you something in the headquarters I'm going to show you once I'm done in this lobby. It has to do with the weapon contracts and stuff. What is your favorite weapon right now? I honestly think I haven't tried the LMG yet. After the LMG, just by shooting this weapon, I like this weapon. I don't think it's going to be my favorite. I still think the Sten is probably the best one to unlock just because, you know, one, it's a classic. Two, is an SMG, and three, it's automatic. You know, it's got the triple combo. I'm really curious to see how this weapon performs. Hoo-yah! Oh, what? What the hell was that? Yo, that was quick. That dude died quick. Oh, what? Holy crap. Damn, this... Bro, you want grenades too, you little... Dude, this gun kills pretty quick. Maybe there's a reason behind the madness, right? Why does it only have 30 bullets in the magazine? Maybe because it shreds ass, bro. Nah, it's actually pretty good. I've never really been a big fan of, like, you know, single shot weapons. That's just not my style. In any shooter game, doesn't matter what it is. I just hate having to compensate my aim every time I shoot one bullet. It irritates the crap out of me. But I do see how this weapon is pretty freaking usable. It's pretty strong. The bullets are strong. I want to say it's a 2-to-3-shot kill. Okay, that was 3 shots, and it was from a far distance without advanced rifling. I died afterwards, but it doesn't really matter. I was just trying to test this out. To be honest, though, the iron sights are fairly easy to use as well, but you can never beat a good reticle, even though these reticles are absolute trash. And I think I left my head back there. All right, 2 shots. He was probably already injured from the last bullets that I... Bro, what is this, bro? This guy thinks he's a face sniper. About to face snipe your mama's ass. By the way, I'm not sure if I've... Hold on. Oh, nice. Ah, damn it. There was 2 people there. I was hoping I'd get all 4 of them. Anyways, I don't think I've inspected this weapon yet. I might have. Probably forgot. One thing I do like about this game, whenever... And I've said this before, and I'll keep saying it. Whenever you have a weapon and it's got a certain variant... You know, color theme. Every single attachment that you put, or at least in my experience so far, every single attachment that I put changes to the same exact color of that weapon variant. Thing I don't like is that the weapon cosmetics doesn't really change when you swap an attachment to accept a red dot sight, or in this case, a reflex, which is kind of unrealistic. The only time it changes is extended mags or a reflex sight. That's it. I guess we got kind of spoiled in Black Ops 3 when everything would change. Oh... That is awesome. They just lined up perfectly for me. By the way, yesterday on stream... Oh, you little son of a... Yesterday on stream, I broke my scuff paddle. I don't remember how it happened exactly, but I can't jump anymore. It was like one of my all-time favorite scuff controllers. I've had it for like almost 2 years already. And I pressed on the paddle extremely hard one of the moments, and it just completely screwed me over. And there you go. As you can see, I've mentioned this before. You can actually use your hip fire to your advantage, and it works so freaking well. Hip fire in this game is so good. Look at him. Again, that's your boy using the freaking Semtech. You want the enemy to go right, you throw that nade on the left. He's going to go right, and then right, whoop-bang. Okay, check this out. When you're shooting a weapon that only shoots one bullet at a time, and I just ran out of bullets on both weapons. So you're trying to shoot a weapon like this that only shoots one bullet at a time. The enemy's really up close. It's really irritating and annoying. The best way to do it, especially in this game, it's so good. Just hit fire. I just tried that twice and it worked amazing. I'm going to try it again. Look at that. What? This game is drunk right now. That wasn't even hit fire distance. That was... What is this, man? You go to Howard. Remember how there is like the order for the Sten? Well, if you've completed the Sten, you can actually, or let's say you unlocked the Sten already in a supply job, either whether you completed it yesterday or unlocked it, disable that order and then just come here and then go for the ice pick. Okay, so if you don't have the ice pick and you already have the Sten, you can do the ice pick instead. Okay, now if you haven't completed the Sten, you can still complete it. I thought it was gonna be like every week we're gonna have a different, like, you know, challenge. I guess you're doing multiple. I guess the orders are not just going to be for weapons. They could also be for different gears or whatever it is. So far, that's what it's looking like. It may not be, but most likely that's what it's going to be. Still don't know what that's for, man. I've seen those multiple times. These freaking airplanes. New orders available in 14 hours. So essentially, it's every 24 hours you're going to have a new order. Whenever you get the weapon that you like, then you can go ahead and do that order instead and disregard or discard the other one that you were doing prior. One bullet, one kill. I'm going to go for hardcore and see how this weapon does on hardcore. All right. Okay. Okay. Ooh. Okay, this is gonna be interesting with this gun. I mean, the gun's already OP as hell. Oh, goodness. Oh, this is hardcore king right here. Got him. Ah! Dude, this gun is awesome for hardcore. I mean, essentially all weapons like this. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna OP the shit out of this gun right now. Okay, so we're gonna have steady aim with the reflex, quick draw, and foregrip with infantry and prime. So this is an overkill right here. We still do not have, we do have extra magazine, which doubles it up. So we have 60 more bullets than we had as opposed to 30, but we still have 10 in the magazine. The ideal thing would be to unlock the magazine and equip it. You son of a bitch. Okay. What? Dude, I mean, the gun's amazing. This gun really is. It really is powerful, but the amount of bullets it's got on a magazine is absolutely disappointing. You need extended mags. Even that, I don't know if 15 bullets in the mag is still enough. Again, these type of weapons are meant to be used in hardcore. Recon aircraft ready. See you right there. What am I supposed to do? Hip fire, as I said, is king with this gun. Hollow tips and tricks, holla at your boy. Really? Okay. Okay. No! Oh my god! What the fuck is that? Got fucking peanut butter and jellied sandwich in there, man. Look, the gun's good. It's got a decent fire rate. Pretty easy to, you know, if you have a quick finger. That's right. It just bothers me that there's barely any bullets. I mean, I'm really not a big fan of, like, one-shot weapons. That's why instead I could have unlocked this with only, like, 1,000 armory credits that I needed, but instead I decided to unlock the Sten because I've just never been a fan of these types of weapons, no matter how sexy and how appealing they are. I mean, I would go and unlock it, but I mean, it says it right there. It gives you 15 instead of 10 and 30. You get 15.45 plus the other, you know, I guess it'd be like 90 in the magazine and the entire weapon, and then 15 in the magazine. Overall, what do I think of the gun? I think the gun's good. I think it shoots fast. I think the power is pretty good. 2-3 shot kill, 1 bullet kill in hardcore almost all the time. I'm really not a big fan of these types of weapons, but overall, the weapon's decent. Nothing to go home and brag to mom about. If I were to choose and I had to choose one, I'd probably go for the LMG or the Sten, as they are automatic and they probably are a little bit more effective, especially in this game, because again, there is some type of skill-based matchmaking. There just isn't. It could be irritating using a weapon like this, but let me know in the comments. I think it looks beautiful. The Baron is absolutely gorgeous. God bless whoever designed it. Looks awesome. But let me know in the comments your thoughts, opinions. Would you go for it? This is even without rapid fire. The rapid fire must be scary as hell. Actually, let me see how. Okay, that is pretty fucking scary.